Guys, welcome to the Wednesday Cardone University Cardone On Demand Mastermind. My name is Steve Spray, coming to you live here from Miami Beach. Dude, it's a great day. It's a great day. Love Wednesdays. Why? Because on Wednesdays, we come to you live so that way we could drop in, and we wanted to do something special for all of the clients who are on Cardone On Demand or who are on Cardone University. And so the point of this call, guys, is so that way we can get together as a group and mastermind. That way we can find out, hey, who's winning in the marketplace? How are they using Cardone University to help them out? How are they using Grant Cardone training to help them elevate their skill level, get to the next level? And so today what we're going to be talking about, handling objections. We're going to be talking about handling objections using Cardone University. So if you guys want to call in, I'm going to answer any question that you have, but I'd love to hear what type of objections you're getting. That way we could get them handled for you on the call today. So if you want to call in, it's 305-865-8668. So that number to call in again, guys, is 305-865-8668. So go ahead and give a call in, and we're going to get y'all set up. We're going to handle any type of objection. And so, you know, what you've learned inside Cardone University is that, look, the objections, you know, they're not that bad. They're typically just complaints. And if you want to be able to start treating them as complaints, if you want to be able to handle them like a pro would, like Grant Cardone would actually handle somebody who's given him an objection and he could just make sense of it. And if you want to get to that level, it requires training. It requires rehearsing, getting the information, getting the data. And so what Cardone University is doing is actually allowing you to be able to get in, train every single day. And so, you know, the point of today's call is for us to get in here. We're going to let you know that, look, we're still doing six segments every single day, okay? That never goes away. Six segments every single day because I want to continue getting better at what I do. I want to continue learning. And I've always got to be going back and learning and practicing and drilling. And so I'm going to show you exactly how to handle any type of problem that you're having in your business today. So if you guys want to call in, it's 305-865-8668. My name is Steve Spray. I'm going to help you out. Handle any objection you guys have. So feel free to call in. But what I want to do is start off with people who are winning with this program. So look, it's no secret, okay? You look at any type of situation, whether it's sports, business, dude, the people who are in the game, the people who are winning the most are the ones who are always elevating their skill level. They're always worried about, hey, what's that next game? How do I get to the next level? How do I get better at what I'm doing? And so for any elite salesperson or anybody who's understands that, look, sales is the lifeblood to your organization, they train every single day. I want to acknowledge some people who have been doing that because we've been having some unbelievable successes. John, look, every morning we got a whole list of people who are calling in on a daily basis who are talking about, dude, I'm killing it, winning it. My team is, I mean, you hear it.
Dude, I don't think I've ever been here and not heard a story like that.
Yeah, we talk about it every single day. So it's because there's so much coming in. So I'm going to acknowledge a few people. I've got a guy named Jim Proctor. He's a sales manager for Bonham Chrysler. Man, these are one of my clients. Awesome guys. Bonham Chrysler. He says, look, we've seen a 2% increase in digital conversion. Okay, if you even know what a 2% increase in digital conversion means for a store like that, let me tell you that it's freaking huge. Okay, because that was a massive, I mean, that's a big deal. That's a lot. That's probably another 80 units per month. Okay. That's another, you know, maybe 200 grand in gross per month. So look, what Randy Carter says, he also works at that store. He says, look, they're doing a lot better with rebuttals and we're seeing quicker closes. So if you're a salesperson and you're seeing managers talk about, hey, look, man, all of a sudden my guys are doing unbelievable with handling objections. They got the right rebuttals. It's because they're doing exactly what we teach them to do inside Cardone On Demand and Cardone University. So guys, if you want to send in your successes, I'd love to share them. Would love to drop in. I mean, we've got people. I just got off a call with a group. I work with a Miracle-Ear franchise. They're up 40%. Okay, they are up 40% this year, year over year, doing unbelievable. So in any type of business, look, you've got to understand the sales. You've got to understand the customer, and you've got to have this pure sales training. That way you know how to handle those objections when they come up. So I'm going to take a caller. I got a call from Andrew from Virginia. If you guys want to call in, because Andrew's getting ready to drop a question he has or a problem he's having, I'm going to show him how to handle it. And so if you want the exact same thing, I want you to call in at 305-865-8668. So, Andrew, how's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
Dude, it's going real good, man. I appreciate you giving a call in today.
Yeah, awesome. Well, let me just kind of get right into it. Actually, I had a rejection today, I guess, RDR.
Okay.
This one has been
Hey, before you do that, Andrew, will you tell us what type of business you're in?
I'm an IT consultant.
So oh, I love that.
IT support, like local business, yeah, local business. And I mean, shoot, if you can go international too, that'd be awesome.
Yeah. So are you making, so what do you do in your business? You make cold calls, warm calls? You hit internet leads?
I do it all. So I do like the, I do the cold calls initially. And then once we make that initial contact, then we, you know, I put them in my CRM, and then I do the follow-ups based off of the stuff that I'm learning off of Cardone University.
Love that. So look, guys, if you're in your business, if you're making cold calls, you're making outbound contacts, you're dropping them in, look, I'm telling you, my guy Andrew, he's having some same problems that you're probably having in your business. So Andrew, what type of problems are you having that we could help you handle?
So it's funny because I usually, when I don't have clients, I'm always, you know, hitting the phones hard. All right, so I just got off of doing some follow-ups.
Okay.
Via the phone. So I had one that was pretty tough. Like this company, I think they're like a dental company. They were like really, really hard to crack. This is like my, I think my second or third time like making a call. But every time I call, you know, she could tell, you know, the gatekeeper that is, you know, she could tell that it's a, you know, it's like a call, you know, a sales call. So before I even get my script out, she's like, no, we're not interested. Thank you. Click. So this time when I called back, she recognized and she said, the doctor's not interested. Bye. Click. So I don't even get a chance to.
You got blacklisted. You
know, yeah.
They put so you on the blacklist. Like,
Exactly. So, you know, it's like I make the updates in the CRM. So I'm like, okay, cool. So I'll call back like next week or something. I may have to be a little bit more creative. So I'm trying to find another creative way to follow up with this company. I tried looking them up on social media. Not much information there. So
yeah. So what you want to do, man, is have you done the training inside Master in the Cold Call where it talks about how to get past the gatekeeper?
Yeah, but I got to review that. I did it once, and I'm
How many things in your life, man, have you done one time and you're just a freaking expert at it? You're so good.
I know exactly.
Come on, man.
So I got to go back and review that.
Exactly.
That part of it.
So this is a very good example, man, and I'm excited that you called in because this is a really good example. I mean, even for me, you know, look, I went through, I did the training, and all of a sudden I'm like, dude, I know it now. And I go out there and I'm still getting my teeth kicked in. You know, look, this is where you've got to learn the training. You've got to understand it. And that's going to get you up a notch. That's going to get you better. But what's going to happen is now you're going to go apply it in the marketplace. And then you're going to need to come back afterwards to say, hey, look, I'm going to go back. I'm going to regroup and I'm going to find out what happened. Right. So that way I can because you're going to watch the content for the second time now that you've actually applied it, you're going to be like, oh my, that's exactly what Grant's talking about right there. So look, before we walk into that, I want to show everybody, you know, look, Andrew called in, he had a question. He's talking about getting past the gatekeeper. And so everything he's talking about is right here inside Master the Cold Call. He's getting an objection right now, who's not even coming from the person he would actually sell. It's coming from somebody else. That's a huge problem because that is a block. That's a roadblock in your business. And so Grant actually created this entire category right here called Getting Past the Gatekeeper. Okay, so this would be step one of understanding, look, how do I approach this the right way? How do I get in on the gatekeeper side? Because you're calling businesses all day long. And, you know, at some point, you can't just, you know, turn the dialer on and then just rock it away and hope that a gatekeeper lets you through. Dude, they're doing their job. Their job is to make sure you don't get through. And so, number one, dude, you got to have your pitch down. You got to have the pitch down right up front. And so when you have that, you understand what the actual pitch is to the gatekeeper, then you're going to sound a lot better. You're going to get on her side. You're going to be figuring out, you know, hey, look, typically when you do a deal like this with a company like mine, hey, what would John be interested in seeing? You know, I'm sure you probably I'm sure everything that comes through this office goes through you first because I'm going to raise her up. So these are some of the things that you're going to see inside the handling the gatekeeper, right? So you want to be able to get those word tracks down where now, look, man, I'm going to get on her side. Maybe I'm going to start using her as a, or it could be him. I'm going to use the gatekeeper as, you know, somebody who could actually help me get the information I need. Because, you know, look, like Andrew said, look, man, I look for him on social media. I'm trying to find a way to get through. I'm trying to do the right recon, but I can't find anything. Okay. They're blank. They don't have anything. How do I start using people in the company to get past them, right? And so what you want to do is you want to watch getting past the gatekeeper. So, John, if you want to show this, I'm going to click inside getting past the gatekeeper. Okay. This is a big objection for everybody. And it's not even an objection. It's just part of the process. And so the way that you handle it is you need to understand it better. And so there's going to be four courses right here. One is, what is the gatekeeper? You've got to understand their position and what's actually happening on that side. Just like understanding the buyer. If you don't understand the buyer, dude, what, how are you going to be able to handle those objections the right way? So you got to understand, what is the gatekeeper? And then we're going to get into, look, act the part. Kill the small talk until you need it, and the power greeting for the gatekeeper. So if you don't have a power greeting for a gatekeeper, if you don't even know what the power greeting for a gatekeeper is, you need it because it's stopping you. And so if you don't have Cardone University right now, or you haven't been to this part of the program, I want you to think with, you know, look, I'm missing deals every single day because I'm getting stopped by something that actually happens to be part of the process. Inside Cardone University and Cardone On Demand, I've got the information that tells me how to handle that. So guys, look, I want you to be able to train on that. If you're doing six training segments every single day, exactly like what we're saying, is Andrew still there? Yeah. So Andrew, look, man, look, what you want to do is, look, you need to use that gatekeeper. Okay. You want to be able to use the gatekeeper as somebody who could help you get further along. So you know what? I'm going to call up and I'm going to be real with her. I'm going to handle her objections like I would inside the program, inside understanding the buyer. Have you been inside understanding the buyer where Grant talks about the magic of agreement?
Yes. First rule of selling. Always agree.
Exactly.
Always agree.
Yeah. You could never train on that content enough, because what happens is every time you go back through it, you get a better understanding. And now I'm thinking with, oh, wow, the gatekeeper's telling me that she'll give, you know, John, who's the CEO of the company, my information, when we both know that she's not writing it down. It's actually never going to get to John, and you just got screened, blacklisted, never going to happen. Look, what you need to understand is that, look, man, use her, right? Use her as somebody who could help you out. So you need to be on her side. I need to be in agreement with her, you know? So I'm calling up and I'm saying, Hey, you know what? I'm sure you probably block everything that comes through here. I'm sure, and I might not even say that. What I might say is, look, I'm sure everything that comes into this office gets funneled through you first. Hey, typically with a company like mine, what do you guys look for when actually getting this data to John? Okay, what's she going to say? Right? Who knows, man? Maybe she drops something. Maybe she says, oh, well, we never look at something like this, right? Now I start going into all those objection handling pieces inside Cardone University, okay? So when somebody tells me that they would never look at it, what's Grant tell you to say? Hey, totally understand you would never look at something like this, but if you did look at it, what would you want to see?
Right.
If you ever let anybody through, okay, because I know you're the gatekeeper of all gatekeepers. You are queen gatekeeper. If you let one deal through, because you guys do business with other companies right now. Do you guys do business with other companies? Okay, she's going to say
absolutely, yeah, sure.
Okay, good. But so I'm going to ask her that. Hey, you guys work with other vendors, right? She's going to be like, yeah, we do. Excellent. Hey, what was the thing that they sent through that helped them out that actually got them a 5 or 10 minute slot on John's calendar? Right? So guys, those are just a few different things. You've got to understand the deal. It's inside Master the Cold Call inside Cardone University. So Andrew, hey, thanks a lot, man, for calling up. Really appreciate that. And if you ever have any other problems, man, you ever have anything, I want you to use that all week long. And I want you to go back. I want you to write these word tracks that I gave you down today. I want you to do the four segments inside Master the Cold Call under handling the gatekeeper. And then I want you to use it all week long. And then next Wednesday, I want you to give me a call back in. I want you to let me know what happened, and we're going to dive in deeper. Okay. Andrew, thanks a lot, man. So we've got another caller who's calling in. So guys, that's what we do on this show every single week. We talk about, this is the Cardone On Demand, Cardone University Mastermind call. So if you're in automotive sales, if you're in SaaS sales, if you're a roofer, if you sell Morgan Stanley's products, if you work for any type of company who has any type of sales at all, which happens to be every company, I want you to call in at 305-865-8668, and I'm going to handle all those problems for you, and I'm going to show you exactly what you need to know inside Cardone University to be able to help you get better at handling those situations. So guys, call in. Do we still have Sean? No? Sean left us. Sean, look, hey man, if you want to give a call back in, we're going to handle any type of problems. So guys, what I want you to know is that, look, as salespeople, there's only really a finite amount of objections that you're going to get, right? And so the more that you know and understand the objections that you're going to get, and that's why this whole month in September, dude, the only thing that we're talking about right now is handling objections, because we get phone calls up here every single day. John, how often is that phone ringing off the hook?
All day, 24/7.
Exactly.
Even on Sundays.
And you know what it is? It's people. They're like, hey, man, I'm getting this objection. Where do I find it? In Cardone University. And of course, we help them out because that's what we're here to do. But what I'm going to tell you is that you've got to get inside the program. You've got to learn the objection handling piece. So there's a couple different areas to do that. Number one, you want to identify, hey, where am I getting the objections at? Is it an objection to a cold call? Is it an objection to a greeting? Is it an objection to me actually presenting my product in a demonstration or presentation format? Is it me getting an objection to saying, hey, look, I just showed you the product, but now I want to give you a contract so that way you can have the numbers? Or is it an actual objection inside the close? And how do I handle every single situation that I'm going to come into? So I'm going to tell you guys right now that for me, you know, look, I never started making real money until I started understanding what was happening in sales. So we want to help you do that. If you guys want to call in, it's 305-865-8668. If you guys want to drop in, or if you guys are leaving me messages here, Rose Har, my favorite client, how you doing today? Appreciate you writing in here to the actual Mastermind webcast. If you guys want to keep your comments down below, what I'm going to do is I'm going to answer them for you right here. So I got Roses in the house. I got Tana. Okay, she's watching Grant's videos. They've changed her mindset and how she handles the customers. Okay, this month we are going to master the cold calls. I'm sitting down with my producer and we will kill it. Okay, you guys got to, you know, look, this is something Grant always talks about. You've got to get that killer that's inside you. You've got to be able to get that thing that isn't all of us. Because look, none of us were born salespeople. None of us were born with the information that we need. Some people may be better at applying pressure in a close, or persisting, or having a good follow-up, because they're like, look, man, I'll just call them until they buy. But at some point, you got to start getting skills. That way you can provide the value when you follow up. That way you can handle the objections. That way you can have a better shot. If you got a lot of opportunities in the marketplace and you're burning through those, or your company is paying for opportunities, look, man, you want to close everything. And it's available, okay? Everything is available. So I got Jacob who's writing in. Thank you. I got Jonathan D. James, excited to learn something new today. So guys, if you want to hear about anything specific, what I'm going to do is handle it for you. I'm going to handle it right here on the call. If you want to call in to 305-865-8668, we're going to get that handle for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into Cardone University. And John, if you want to show them my screen right here, I'm going to talk about, look, where do you guys get objections at? What are you getting objections to? Because when we hear, I got people who call up and they're talking about, hey, I'm getting an objection, you know, and I'm like, well, where are your objections at? They're like, well, you know, I don't know. You know, look, you guys have got to identify those. So in the program, like, I'm going to click inside sales process. For me, this is what I learned first, because I wanted to get inside. I wanted to learn, hey, look, man, every time I get into a greeting situation, somebody's like, nope, they're giving me that big hand. That's why we actually put up the big hand right there on objections in the greeting. So you guys are going to see that. There's 11 segments of content inside just handling objections in the greeting. And so there's going to be a lot of different ways that you can handle different objections, because the objections are going to be different, right? So I'm going to get inside objections in the greeting. I got to understand them first. I got to understand, look, why would somebody object to me from the start? Dude, we haven't even done anything yet. I just said, what's up? I just said, how you doing? I just came in. I just said, welcome. And now all of a sudden they're objecting to me. They're dropping the hand. They're putting it in my face. They're saying, not happening. Look, this is what you've got to understand up front before you start diving into, hey, look, what is the difference between a want and ask? And how do I start initiating objections in the greeting? Okay, because I'll tell you, that segment there was a complete, that's why you see a heart by it. That's why you see a big heart right next to this one, because for me, I'm like, hey, look, man, I want to be able to initiate these up front. The way I don't have to handle them later. So you're going to see those segments inside that part of the category that basically tell you everything you need to know. So whether it's a time objection, You know, somebody talking about, hey, look, I want to speak to the manager, or they're calling up and you're a salesperson and they're like, hey, look, I already know that I get the best deal from the guy who runs the company, the guy who's the vice president, the guy who's the manager, the sales manager, the desk manager, the area manager. I want to talk to them. How do you actually handle that as a salesperson? Because, dude, you don't want to hand it off to somebody else, man. Be a pro, okay? Step your game up. Learn the information inside Cardone University. So there's going to be a tool that we have inside this part of the program that, you know, we go in and we handle every single objection you'll get, okay? This is called Handling Objections Up at the Top. Okay, if you're on Cardone On Demand, the name of that tool, it's in the same spot. It's actually called Quick Fix Solutions, okay? So what is a quick fix solution? Okay, a quick fix solution is not necessarily a training segment. It's actually, hey, look, man, I just need to get a word track. You know, and this is where we get a lot of people. If you guys want to call in right now, we're going to handle those questions. So I want to hear what objections you're getting. Okay, you drop in an objection to me, I'm going to fire off exactly what you need to know. Okay, give me any objection. I'm going to be able to handle it. That's the type of confidence I have after actually learning Grant Cardone's material about how to handle any type of objection ever and treat it as a complaint. So you guys can call in to 305-865-8668. And so this part of the program is called the Quick Fix Solutions Tool. And the reason why Grant created it was because he said, look, man, the way that we're going to make people more effective is throughout the day if we're actually giving them solutions when they have different problems. Okay, so think about your sales team. Think about different situations you have every single day. You got a sales team. You got maybe 10 people, 50. Maybe you got 100 employees. Man, everybody's got a different problem all day long, all throughout the day. Okay, I got one sales guy who's getting one objection, another sales guy with another. For me, I'm getting different objections every single day. How do I get better every single day? You need to be able to get the word tracks. You got to be able to do that. And so Quick Fix Solutions, or the Handling Objections tool, is exactly why Grant created that. So John, if you want to show this right now, I'm going to click inside to Handling Objections. That's up at the top. And we're going to block this off. So it is categorized to objections. And this is everything before you even present numbers to a customer. Most salespeople don't even know where they're getting the objections at. So they need to be able to identify, hey, look, where are you actually getting these? This is going to give you a better understanding. And then you're going to go into closes. 219 different objection strategies to be able to use. So there's probably 4 or 5 different ways to handle every single one. So whether it's I'm just looking, we're not buying today, or it's I got to talk to the spouse, we don't make a rash decision. Those are the types of strategies that you're going to find inside closes. But when I go inside objections, you know, look, this is where you get in and identify, look, where am I getting that objection at? And so right now in the middle of the day, I don't need a specific big training set. I just want to get a quick solution. I'm going to do it fast because I'm going to do this all day long. And I'm going to do this on my phone, and I'm going to pull it up, and I'm going to say, okay, I just got this objection in the greeting. Somebody didn't want to talk to me. They walked into my company and they said, hey, look, I'm just here and I am just looking. So we've got all these different strategies right here of customers saying that they are just looking. So when I jump inside this part of the system, I'm going to see how quick this video is. And it's going to be extremely fast. So I'm going to take a question from Joseph, who just called in, because Joseph's going to drop me the problem that he's having right now, and I'm going to handle it for him. So, Joseph, you on the line? Joseph, how you doing, Hello? Sir? Hey, how's it going?
Hello.
Hey,
I'm calling from Italy.
Are you calling all the way from Italy? Man, I really appreciate you being on.
It's far away. I hear you very bad.
Okay. I apologize, man. That's my fault, not yours. What type of problem are you having?
I'm having a problem in these last days. I'm on Cardone U, and I've gone through I think about the 50% of the videos, but just to try and excuse my English first of all.
Oh, no problem, man. It sounds great.
Just to go through all the techniques and whatever. It's being hard for me lately because you know, Grant says income first to be wealthy. Okay, I have to worry about my job. The question, the problem is that sometimes I just don't have, it's not true time to go on the Cardone U, but with all the things happening around, all the problems, now it's about 10 days, I just can't go on Cardone you for one question or another. How do you, does this ever happen to you or happen in the past?
No, it did. It used to, you know, so you don't have time or you don't have priorities.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Because look, how much money are you going to make? Let's be real. So how much money are you going to make this year? I mean, if everything stays the same month over month, every month, you know, how much money are you going to make at the end of the year?
About 120.
Okay, good. 120 euros. What is real for you right now? What is real for you, Joe? Could you make 200?
No, I just went through to make millions, you know, so I want to do that, but...
Okay, good. So, I mean, is it worth it to you? Is it worth it to you every single day to basically scratch whatever you're doing off your morning that costs you 20 minutes to pull up Cardone University? That way you can get your deal better every single day. Because, look, it's easy, man. It's easy to get out of the routine. Okay, you're not always doing what you're supposed to be doing, but that's the part. That's why we do the Cardone University Mastermind. That way we can get back together and I can tell you, hey, Joe, dude, knock it off. Get your deal back together. Get back on Cardone U every single day. You know it's what you're supposed to be doing. It's like eating right, man. It's, you know, you don't always do it, but then you're like, you know what? I'm going to get my deal back together because I'm sick of being overweight. I'm sick of not getting what I want. And so until you actually feel that where you're like, look, man, I'm done. Okay, so for me, when I finally said, I'm sick of this, dude, that was when I dug in. And it wasn't six segments for me. I was doing 12, 18. Dude, I was doing 30 and 45 minutes of training every single day because I was done with actually having all the problems that I have because they were little baby problems, you know. And so I wanted to step it up, man. I wanted to get to the millions. I wanted to be able to drop a big check to Grant on some sort of investment. That's what I wanted to do. But I knew that I couldn't do that if I kept making excuses like, hey, look, man, I don't have 15 minutes. I'm so busy making 120 euros. Okay, so we're, you know, so good. Hey, Joe, look, man, give me a call. I'm going to help you out. If you want to give me a call anytime, dude, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to get a plan together for you. Okay, so if you want to email me, steve@grantcardone.com, I'm going to send you a game plan for the day that's going to tell you exactly what to do. That way you can find some slots that'll be easier for you to get your training in every day. Does that sound good?
Sounds very good.
My man. Hey, I appreciate you calling in, dude. You have an unbelievable day. And look, I appreciate you calling in from Italy. I got Rose calling in from Florida.
Hi there.
Rose, how you doing today?
I'm really good. Hey, we've got a question for you.
Yes.
Well, we have an opportunity where our software would be bringing in around $250,000 a year. With a hospital, not hospital, but a clinic that has 47 locations.
Okay.
And our main competitor had a pilot in and failed. And so they're like super happy to have us come in. But now they're giving us, why do you think you're worth that much a year? And so yesterday during our meeting, we were like, well, what would Grant do? And we all thought, well, we think he would, and we all threw out all these ideas. But so they told us that we had exactly what they needed, but now they're like, we don't know if our competitor, we're all getting paranoid, right?
Right.
They're saying, oh, we're going to look at somebody else. What makes you think you're worth so much a year? Maybe they don't pay that much for their whole system. And we're doing, you know, their front end and their payments.
Right.
And that type of thing, but we're not their EMR.
Right.
And so now we're getting all nervous that maybe we're too expensive. We're losing our cool a little. We're not sure how to get our mojo back.
I'm with you, Rose, and thank you for sending that in. So basically, you know, one thing that you would want to do that I always ask before I set up a deal like that, I'm always asking them, hey, have you ever done this before? You know, that way I can get a feel for, and you're going to find this inside the fact finding and the material that basically sets up your presentation, where you're really feeling out people's understanding of what you do. And hey, have they ever done this before? Because you may drop a big $250,000 contract on their desk and they're like, whoa, when we first originally thought about doing this, we were thinking like maybe 60 grand for the year, not 250. And all of a sudden you kind of freaked us out. And so what you need to do in this case is make the problem much bigger, because they don't have a $250,000 problem. They probably have a $3 million or a $5 million problem that you're going to be able to solve for them. And so you got to be able to make that bigger.
We haven't done yet.
That's what I would do.
We need to have to go through it, because we can prove that every clipboard is costing them $50,000 a year. And if they have 47 locations, I mean, just the math on that. So I know we can certainly prove that we're worth it. But if, you know, they're buying MRI units and all these other expensive units that don't cost as much, as we certainly can bring it. But I'm just wondering if we're going to have to discount. And so what if, you know, we're going to go ahead and show them the return on investment, and they, you know, we may have to, how do we find out about our competitor and if who these competitors are, or do you think they're just blowing smoke?
I always ask them, you know. Because the one thing that I've learned inside Cardone University is Grant talks about, hey, look, man, confront the problems, right? Like,
yes.
We always talk about, this might be too soon. The gorilla in the room, dude, take it down. Okay, so I'm going to ask them. You know, I'm going to let them know up front. I'm going to say, hey, look, you know, I understand that, you know, you thought that this was going to be the right proposal for you. Maybe you thought it was going to be something a little bit different. Hey, let me ask you this. Are you looking at any other opportunities out there in the marketplace right now? Okay, what do you like best about what we've shown you versus what might be something that could add to this? Or is this too much product for you, right? So when you go inside some of the demonstration training, you're talking about, Grant's going to show you that how to really give people options. And I'm going to show people high options. I'm going to show them low options. And then that way, I talked about this 2 weeks ago in a mastermind, where inside the demo, if you set the negotiating parameters yourself, that way they don't have to shop in their head. Because whether they're out there in the marketplace shopping or not, they are shopping. They are out there, and they're actually, because what they're doing is they're sitting here on the phone with you, or they're in the middle of the deal with you. You've got a longer sales cycle, and they're sitting here thinking, man, is this the right deal for us? Is 250 grand gonna solve our problem? I mean, maybe your deal's too small. Maybe they don't think that what you provided them. So what I might do is I might say, because you're gonna see this inside the follow-up tool where it talks about offer other options. Hey, I thought about something else. The reason that you wanna do that, so you're gonna see this on day one. You're gonna see on day one follow-up inside the follow-up tool. I'm inside follow-up right now, actually, looking at reasons why people do not buy from you. There's a segment in there that talks about concern about cost. And so that's what I want you to go through. And I want you to go through the ones that you think might apply in this situation under reasons why people do not buy from you. And so when you do that inside follow-up, it's going to help give you a better understanding. And Rose, what that's going to allow you to do is figure out, hey, what's actually going on with this deal? And
Well, we love the system because we are in it every single morning, and we're role playing every single day.
I know you guys.
So I knew you could help us there.
Yeah, good. So here's what I would do is I would maybe so on day one follow up, Grant talks about, you know, look, offering other options, call somebody up. Hey, you know what? Something came across my desk. I thought that it might be perfect just based off the conversations we had. I wanted to throw it out there, because what happens is that when you give people options, they start canceling those other options out. Even when you know that you're sitting here thinking, hey, I'm going to send this to her. She's not going to want that. Okay, what she's going to actually do is get more certain on what she does want, which is the deal you presented in the first place, because you are the expert. Mm-hmm. You're the one who knows what's going to solve her problem. But she's got this thing going on in her head right now where she's thinking like, oh, my God, is this going to do it? Is it not going to do it? Is this too much? We've never done anything like this. I mean, you don't even know what's going on. So you want to be able to kind of control that. And so what you'll find inside the sales process inside And at this point, it's a little bit different because you're past the demo at this point. But maybe you could go back and do this for your understanding now, because that's what Cardone University is about. It's about pinpointing these problems in real time and then getting a solution. That way, I don't make these mistakes anymore. And so when you go inside – John, show my computer. So when you go inside the sales process right here, I'm inside what's called the presentation. And there's going to be a couple different segments of content that talk about selection, verify selection with alternatives, more alternatives. And I'm going to go through these. That way I can identify, hey, how do I set the negotiating parameters? Okay, good. Yeah, so Rose, maybe offer them something different, like a another option or a bigger package. Because what happens is you keep hitting on the same thing over and over and over. And then what might happen now is you throw something else in there and you're like, hey, what if we did this? And they're all of a sudden like, no, that doesn't work. What we were doing before works. Okay, would you like for them to say that?
Awesome. And this is going to be recorded so I can show this at my meeting?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay, good. Yep. Thank you for this. This is great.
Absolutely. And Rose, Rose, since you're on our enterprise account, you know that we do sales meetings for you every single month. So if you just get with Robin, put a sales meeting, put a sales meeting on my calendar this month, and I want to do one for you guys.
Okay. All right. We'll do it. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Rose. All right. We're gonna take Roddy from LA.
Hey, how's it going?
Roddy, my man. How you doing this week?
Hey, good to hear from you, and great show today.
Oh, thanks a lot, man. I really appreciate you always calling in. How's everything been going for you?
Everything's going well. I'm calling about a speaking client. It's a kind of an objection. I know that's what the show is on today.
Yep.
Basically, there's like it's a nonprofit, and the CFO type asked if I would come back because I did well last year.
Yeah.
And I'm going to just share some numbers. Maybe it'll be helpful for some of the people here. And basically, it was last year it was $6,000.
Okay.
So they said, we want you to come back. And they first asked, you know, what we need to find out what days in October we can have you come back. And I'm like, great, I'm getting back in real quick. And then they take like 3 weeks to get back. So then they said, well, how much would your fee be? And I said in an email back, well, basically the fee is hopefully at the high end of your spectrum. And then I shared another nonprofit that, and I just said they paid me 12 and this corporation paid me 25. And I said, I'm not sharing those numbers to scare us out of an opportunity. Those are just facts. And just let me know what's in your budget. And I'm just trying to get him to go higher,
right?
Because in my business, he's in South Dakota. Sometimes these bigger numbers are okay in maybe LA or New York or Chicago, but in South Dakota, those are scary. So, but this guy has just gone away. So I did what we talked about a month ago. I did octopus on him.
Yeah,
two emails, two texts. Left four voicemails. I didn't feel uncomfortable doing that at all.
Okay.
I think that was all really good and still haven't heard back, which is, it's odd for me because typically I get that treatment when no one's ever seen what I've done. But I've already proven myself to them. So I thought at least they would get back to me. And so, I know he's got ideas, but I had an idea. There is a CEO type who is like kind of a big fan of mine. I was thinking about just going to him next and I didn't want to go over the head of the CFO guy, but
okay.
I just wanted to hear what you had to say about my story.
Okay, yeah, absolutely, man. So I'm gonna basically handle that for you. And
yeah,
what I want to do right now is talk about, you know, look, have you used the follow-up tool? So the follow-up tool goes 365 days. So you know what you're gonna find is that 80% of most transactions or the people getting back to you, you're gonna find out that, you know, look, there's reasons why they're not buying from you. So if you click inside follow-up, you click inside follow-up and you go in there to reasons why people don't buy from you, there are categories and segments where Grant talks about, look, this is what you do when this is the actual situation. So I'm just going to rattle a couple off for the purposes of the show today. But look, lack of time, personal issues, concern about cost, cash flow, budget constraints, more pressing problems, able to carry on without, right? So these are things. So maybe that's the problem, man. Maybe the guy's able to go on to the show. He's like, look, man, we could do this deal. I don't need Roddy, right? I don't need writing his 25K speaking fee, right? If that is the case, look, Grant's going to tell you how to handle that in there. So that may not be the case, but it could be, you know, uncertainty, right? Or any of these different problems. There's 17 different problems inside reasons why people do not buy from you. And so it'd be great for you to go in there and really get that data from Grant. So what I would suggest is, you know, look, man, call it out. Get in front of the guy. I wouldn't ever ask anybody what their budget is. When I talk about speaking, what I would look for is, hey, my speaking fee is $25,000 for me to fly up, do a customized speech for you. And do you guys typically budget something like this for an event? Right. So I want to ask that up front. I want to find out, hey, what, you know, it's a way of asking, you know, what do you budget without saying, you know, hey, what would you pay me? And basically,
yeah,
you know, so I'm going to tell the guy, yeah, hey, I just did an event last month. I was in L.A. Okay. I actually lowered my speaking fee from $35,000. Okay. We did $25,000 for that event because of the opportunities that were available. Do you typically budget $35,000 for a speaking event? You know, and the guy's like,
they typically run, but if I got them on the phone, I guess that's different. I guess some of that running is when I share that on email.
Yeah, because he's gonna act like he's got the deal. You know, he's gonna be acting like. So what I might ask is, hey, what, you know, hey, no problem, no problem. Hey, I'm actually, you know, me, I'm willing to look at anything. So, you know, what other opportunities would you have available? Do you run two or three of these events each year? You know, so now I start figuring out, hey, what's the deal? But I'm actually in control of it. And so I'm asking the guy, hey, you know, hey, you know, look, man, because maybe I could do the deal at 15, you know, if you got three events this year. Or, you know, because that way you start setting the negotiations yourself. And then you can really kind of feel the guy out where, you know, maybe he's like, ah, you know what, we probably actually never would budget something like that for this. And that's that way you can really figure the guy out in the situation. And that way you don't have to get to a point where the guy goes dark on you on follow up and you got to figure out, hey, man, how do I actually kill this, you know, giant freaking gorilla of just a speaking fee that I threw out there that I should be getting, but I would be willing to do it for a different price. Right.
I think that's great for my next guy.
Right.
This particular situation. I had done it before for six, and I thought I had proven myself. So I was just going, let's just go up from there.
Yeah, for me,
that got me cornered a bit. You're saying?
Yeah. Well, no, but it's all right, man. Because for me, what I always do is I always just like call him out. Like, you know, I always ask the guy, you know, hey, look, seemed like things were going really well. Hope you're not dodging me. Hey, here's a great link on an event that I did for a group in LA. Thought you might like it.
Okay.
Yep.
So just octopus the guy again right now.
I'm going to octopus the guy, man. I'm not going to slow down on follow-up. Maybe I might crank the follow-up. I might just crank it up, dude, so I can turn it up. Sometimes I need to find out, hey, look, man, is there a deal here? You know, or you could even ask the guy, send him a quick message. I want you to do this. If you can't get him and he opens his emails or you got a text message, I want you to send him, Roddy, any chance we could connect for a brief call? Had a new idea, wanted to run it by you. Okay. There's a little bit of mystery built in there, and I want to keep throwing that out there. Like, you know, hey, look, man, I had a new idea. Wanted you to know about it. Okay, because he might be thinking like, oh, maybe he came to his senses on the pricing. When really, you did come to his senses. You're still worth the money. You're still going to do the deal, but you're going to find out a different way to do it.
What about going to the CEO, who I know is a fan of mine? Does that start to? I mean, I actually don't have a problem doing that if I'm polite about it.
Right.
But I was kind of afraid of perhaps somebody having their feelings hurt. But I'm like, I can say, look, I reached out to this guy 8 times and I can't get a hold of him.
Yeah, you know what I would do is I would message that guy or something. I'd let him know, hey, man, I've been talking to your guy, John. Looking forward to doing your guys' event this year. You know, how's everything going with you? You know, start some actual communication with that guy and then get into it with them. And then, you know, maybe he'll let you know what the real deal is because the other guy – you know, you don't know what the deal is right now. And that's where you're going to find inside follow-up. If you go in there where reasons people don't buy from you, Grant's going to give you the actual strategies when it is that particular situation. So, Roddy, dude, always appreciate you giving a call in. Hey, before you go, who do you know who I could call today that hook up with Cardone University? I'm going to call him on this call.
I love it. I have a good friend. I don't know what he would say or do, but
get him on three-way.
You want to do it right now?
Dude, call the guy.
Right now?
Let's do a live call, dude. Let's do it.
Okay. Gary Poole.
Gary Poole, dude. I love Gary.
No, Gary Poole, P-O-O, P as in Paul, O-O-L-E.
Let's do it.
And
warm me up, man. Tell him you got Grant Cardone's guy on the phone. He's got a program. Dude, this is the deal for you.
So, you wanting me to call him or you want me to give you his number right now?
You know what we could do, Ronnie, is we could definitely wait, absolutely. But if we did it right now, we could probably get him on the line. We could probably get a deal shut down. By the end of the show, I could help out your guy.
Well, and that's what I'm asking you. Did I give this number live?
I don't know
if I'm live or not.
Okay, my team's saying no. Ronnie, look, man, hey, let's get together after the show, man. I really appreciate you giving me a referral. I'm going to help you out. we can chat about your speaking deal. Okay. Roddy, okay. Thanks a lot, man. Hey, have an awesome week. Hey, I got Patricia from Texas. Guys, if you want to call in, look, I'm going to answer your questions. I'm going to handle any type of question that you have. So call in 305-865-8668. This is the Cardone University Mastermind. We got Patricia from Texas. Patricia, how you doing?
Hi, doing great. Thanks for taking the call.
Yeah, thanks for getting
on. And forgive me, I'm still in the learning process with regard to Cardone. I do follow him socially. We did purchase a couple of small packages from Cardone where we get the webinars
before
and so forth.
Before I answer that, hey, have you signed up for this month for the Mastering Objections program that Grant's created that has the 150 page? Look, there's a 50 plus page ebook. Have you signed up for that?
No, not yet.
Let me write that down. Yeah, you want to get that. So it's masteringobjections.com. Masteringobjections.com. There's a 50 plus page ebook.
Okay.
Okay. And he's going to keep building onto that. Okay. I've been working for Grant for a long time. Good. I know the guy. That book's going to be sick. Okay. There's going to be a 40 minute live play by play. So if you've seen any of the live calls that Grant does in the office, we had one that we never sent out. Okay, the call was ridiculous. It was awesome, but we never put it out just because there were some things in there that, you know, and finally Grant said, hey, look, man, I'm going to cut it up. I'm going to do it play by play, and I'm going to send it out. So it's a never before seen live video.
Oh, perfect.
And then there's going to be 15 specific objection handling deals. And then he's been creating a rebuttal book. Okay, this thing's going to be probably almost 200 pages. So do you get objections in your business?
Absolutely. That's why I'm calling.
Good. So we're going to handle all of those inside Cardone University, and we've got a new rebuttal book coming out right now that's going to come along. So masteringobjections.com is where that's handled. Patricia, what question do you have today that I can help you out with?
Okay. So real brief. So what I do is a lot of outbound calls. We sell financial product, basically. We provide cash flow. And I service the whole nation. And so my problem, my objective is that a lot of the leads that we have, I call them needle in a haystack because, I mean, they're deals, calls that I have to make. And we do constant contact. In other words, all the leads that we have thousands and thousands of leads, uh-huh. You know, phone numbers and emails, people that have contacted us because they, you know, were interested at one point, but maybe they didn't go forward.
Okay.
So they're not completely dead, but they're pretty dead. So, You know, I'm doing, you know, several calls a day, and my deal is, first of all, who are you? What do you want? You know, they don't remember. And then once I refresh, well, you were in contact with me a couple of years ago, you were interested, in our product. And specifically, it's invoice factoring. And so once they, I remember who you are. Well, I'm not interested. I mean, just that quick. And so, you know, again, needle in haystack, every once in a while, I'm like, I'm interested. Go ahead and send me what you got. But in most cases, I don't need it anymore. You know, I'm factoring, or I got my finance through my bank, or what have you.
Yeah, so you're calling somebody up. They don't want the financial product anymore. You're trying to resell them, and you're looking for what you call the needle in a haystack. You know, around here we call it low-hanging fruit. You know, things that people who, you know, they raise their hand, they're like, hey, I'm interested. You know, you call them up.
Yeah, at one point.
Which doesn't happen often. I mean, how many phone calls do you have to make before you get one person who says, hey, Patricia, oh, my God, thank you for calling. I can't wait to get started. How many calls do you know that you have to make to get that one person who says yes?
I would say probably about 50.
50?
At least 50, yeah.
Okay, good. And how many phone calls do you make per day?
I make about 50 a day.
Okay, so you're doing about one deal per day.
I'm getting like one, maybe one interested a day. And, you know, there's a lot of other things I do, too. I'm not just doing that, but, you know, doing the social
and
advertising, all this other stuff. So I try to get in at least five. But, and then we got, of course, the folks that are the new leads coming in through our website and our 800 number and what have you. But in between, I have to go.
Are you on what products of Grant's do you have?
The two that we first deal that we got was like $49, and we got like these slides and so forth. I want to say it was like MP3 with, I want to say it was like 100.
How to make millions on the phone.
Yeah, and so, and then most recently we got one with, it was like, forget it actually.
Yeah, so here's what I want you to do.
Had the million on the phone, yeah, exactly. Sell or be sold.
Yeah, here's what I want you to do, because I definitely want you to sign up for the webcast that we're doing this month with the rebuttal book, because you need to be able to get your people prepared. So I would load all your people up at masteringobjections.com. And then if you also go to masterthecoldcall.com, there's going to be a program there that you're going to be able to get, because you got to be able to get a pitch down. You got to be able to get tight, and you got to be able to know, look, what am I going to expect on the call every single day? Okay, because you make 50 calls every single day. You wake up every morning and you probably know exactly what you're going to face, right?
Yeah, and it gets old. That's why
I
get to do other things, because that would get real
right. And so, and here's what happens. So, because I've been there. So what happens is that, you know, look, you come into the office, you start making your calls, you get brushed off, and then you just get all frustrated because you're like, you know, I mean, I just can't take this anymore. I can't do it anymore, and I'm sick of it. I'm sick of getting my teeth kicked in every single day. Cold calling is tough, and you're never going to get good at it until you get that frequency up. So what Grant says is that, look, frequency before good. You got to get good. So if I were you, I would figure out a way to block off a timetable inside your day that allows you, like, let's just say from 11 to 3 o'clock, you don't do anything but generate new business, because let's be honest, that is the lifeblood for every organization. So you set that apart. So now all of a sudden, instead of making 50 calls, you're making 100, or maybe you can even get to 150. Okay, so your frequency starts getting up. You're going to bat more often. But what you need to be able to get is, you got to have the right script, and then you've got to be able to get these rebuttals on the objection handling. And so that's why this entire month we're talking about handling objections, because you make the phone calls. Okay, not everybody answers. But when they do answer, the majority of them say, I'm not interested. We already looked at that. We would probably never look at that. I keep all my money in my bank account. I don't know what to do with my money, so I'm not giving it to anybody. I'm putting it under my mattress, right? So who knows what type of objection you run into, but you've got to be able to have the rebuttals to get into. So if you do the mastering objections piece, that's going to help you out unbelievably. You're going to get that big book, and you're going to get all the videos of Grant actually on a cold call handling objection after objection after objection. So you definitely want to do that. But what you want to do is, look, get to 100 phone calls. For those of you on Cardone University, one piece that I'm going to show you, John, if you want to show my computer, I'm going to go inside Mastering the Cold Call. Inside this part of the program, there's a lot of pieces where she's talking about, Patricia says, hey, look, man, I'm making these calls every day. Look, you got to get the cold call process down right here, where, you know, what do you do before the cold call? What do you do inside this part of the program where I'm learning, hey, what are the big claims? What are the fact finding? Because everybody's going to tell you no, because Patricia, they really don't know what you have. They don't know what type of, they're not even going to give you a chance or an opportunity. And so for you to get a little bit of extra time on that call, in that opportunity, you got to know exactly what to do. And then that's where the part down here where we're talking about the cold call objections. Okay, there's 12 different objections that you're going to get. Somebody says, I'm not interested. I am busy. I don't have time. Send me some information. Not the decision maker. No budget. Let me try. Let me get some free access, right? All these different objections that you're going to get, you got to know how to handle them. You got to have the rebuttals. And so, guys, look, every single Wednesday, what we're going to do, we're going to come to you live. We're going to come to you live right here. This is called the Cardone University Mastermind. The reason why Grant wanted us to do this was so that we could put this together and we get people like Patricia. I got Roddy calling in. Roddy's trying to figure out, dude, how do I go from a $5,000 speaking fee to $25,000? Okay. And we're going to show him how to do it. I know he's doing good in his business right now. Okay. Because I talked to him. He's here every week. He's made the commitment. He says, look, dude, I'm committed. I'm staying in the mastermind. And what happens is that, look, we all come together so that we can start talking about, hey, what challenges are you having? What problems are you having? So if you guys ever want to call in, you do that, and we're going to handle them for you right here on this call. And then we're going to show you how to use Cardone University or Cardone On Demand to be able to maximize your potential. Because let's face it, you can get better every single day. If you're sick of making 30 grand a year and you want to make 100, dude, let's do it. You got to get committed to what you're doing. You got to show up every week to the Cardone Mastermind, and you got to be on Cardone University. Okay, you guys want to take it, your six-figure income from 100,000 to $1 million per year? We're going to show you how to do that. So guys, every single Wednesday, 2 p.m., we come to you live. Grant Cardone, Cardone University, Cardone On Demand. We're going to help you out. My name is Steve Spray. Appreciate you guys being on this week. You guys have an unbelievable... See you soon.